Hi, Nijo.
Hello again, sir. And how may I help you this time?
What do you know about that couple?
Oh, they're American.
Is that all?
The chap's a little odd. As for the lady, it's a funny thing. But I get the impression she's a lot cleverer than she's letting on.
I met an interesting guy earlier, a cab driver.
Ah, that would have to be Utar, a barbaric sort of chap.
Oh, he's not that bad.
You know how he speaks in pidgin English? That's how he speaks in Arabic, too.
Who's the guy selling the kebabs?
Oh, that's Arto. A miserable blighter, to be sure, sir.
He doesn't seem very happy.
He never is. Day in, day out, a face like a wet Wednesday. Whatever one of those is.
Does he speak any English?
Not cogently, no.
Look, this is going to sound a bit strange, but I need Arto's brush.
What? The brush he bastes the kebabs with?
Yes.
Let me find some dirty postcards for you instead.
Nijo, this is serious. Arto stole that brush he's using from a friend, and I want to get it back.
Perhaps I could help you, old chap. Maybe? Perhaps?
Maybe what? Perhaps what?
I do not wish to seem mercenary, sir, but I am a merchant, and merchants trade.
Merchant? This isn't Sears and Roebuck here.
Well, if you're going to be disagreeable...
No, you're right. What would you like?
I seem to recall that you have something that might alleviate my boredom. A globe of delight. A Rubicon spheroid of heavenly pleasure.
You mean the ball, don't you?
A tiny spherular form that barely spans my hand, yet promises hours of amusement.
If you mean the ball, why don't you just say so?
Can I have the ball back, mister?
All right, here you go.
Thank you, sir. People say bad things about Americans, but you're okay in my book.
What people? What bad things?
Never mind that now. Remember the brush?
Right, yes, the brush.
All you have to do with Arto is be polite. It lightens his day. Makes it all worthwhile for him again.
How can I be polite to the guy when I can't speak a word of Syrian?
Arabic.
That's what I meant.
Simply memorize this phrase. Il ach il kalb.
Il ach il kalb.
Close enough. Now, go over to Arto and deliver those honeyed words even unto his delicate ear. He won't be able to do enough for you.
Really?
Really.
So long, Nijo.
Toodle pip, sir.
Hello again, sir.
Hello. Kebab? Yes?
Il akul kalb?
Filthy! Bad! Bad! I'll kill you!
Whoa! Calm down! I just... Feet, do your thing! What the heck did you tell me to tell him?
Patience, sir.
Patience? Patience? I've been chased by a homicidal kebab seller, and you expect me to be patient?
But consider, sir, while you were running from the irate Arto wasn't using the brush.
Hold on. Are you telling me that I've been used as a diversionary tactic?
Your brush, sir.
I can't believe that you put me on that kebab seller's death list for a toilet brush.
The ends justify the means, sir.
Yeah, but I notice it wasn't your butt that was on the line, though.
They also serve who only stand and wait, sir.
Oh, spare me. Thanks for getting the brush and risking my life to do it.
Anytime. Glad to be of service.
So long, Nijo.
Toodle pip, sir.
Hello again, Ultar.
Praise be to Allah. I am blessed with your bountiful presence once more.
What does Il Akal Kalb mean?
Who teach you that?
Najo told me to say it to Arto.
And Arto come after you with big knife, yes?
Yeah, how did you know?
I know Arto. You tell him in bad Arabic that his kebab's made from dog meat.
I said he was using dog food? No wonder he went crazy.
No. Ultar not mean meat for dog. Ultar mean meat of dog.
Oh. Ew. Look, I've got the toilet brush back.
You man of action, alrighty. Don't just wave at me. Give to manager.
See you around, Ultar.
May good fortune follow you, mister.
There wasn't much point in trying to launch an in-depth conversation when I couldn't speak Arabic and he couldn't speak. Period. Here's your brush, sir. It wasn't easy getting it back. The manager took the brush from me, gave me the toilet keys as my reward, and stomped off. What was all that about?
Manager, he say, bah! Look at state of this. Need much cleaning and detergent before go around my, you bend.
He said all that?
Body language account for much, you know? Oh, yes, indeedy.
I knew the door was locked. I'd need the key to get in there. It was a roller towel dispenser. The towel sat in the open dispenser like a wad of dirty chewing gum. The dispenser had opened easily enough. There didn't seem much point in closing the dispenser. The mirror was as clean as anything else in there. And I thought the French had strange toilets. I hadn't drunk anything since the morning, and I didn't need to use it. The design of the toilet was a little different from what I was used to, but a toilet chain is a toilet chain all over the world. Oops. The fall hadn't done the statuette much good.
It had lost its arms and gotten pretty chipped.
Hi, Nijo.
Hello again, sir. And how may I help you this time?
No way. Do you recognize these keys?
No.
What does this toilet chain mean to you?
Are you building a bathroom in easy installments?
May I have this statuette? It is broken after all.
Certainly. And when my father deals with that feline for breaking it, you can have a Davy Crockett hat as well.
So long, Nijo.
Toodle pip, sir.
Hello again, Pearl.
Why, hello, George. It's such a pleasure to see you again.
Have you had anything from the kebab stand?
Heavens, no, with my digestion.
Have you ever heard of a hill called the Bull's Head?
No. No, I haven't. Is it nearby?
I'm not sure.
Sounds awful romantic. The Bull's Head Hill.
Do you know what Il Akel Kalb means?
My, sounds romantic.
Yeah, I don't think it is, though. Have you met the taxi man, Ultar?
Heavens, yes. What a big man. Very muscular.
But you didn't go for a ride.
Why, George, you're absolutely the most... Oh, you mean a taxi ride? No, Dwayne wasn't interested, so it didn't happen.
Look, a washroom towel.
Oh, George, you poor, poor thing. You've had a touch of the sun.
No, I'm fine, really. I've got the keys to a toilet here.
With my digestion, you better keep them handy. But I'm terrible.
What do you think of this toilet chain?
My, but you're a strange one, George.
Are you interested in antiquities?
Am I? What have you got there, George?
How about this fine statuette?
Oh, George, that would be ideal, except, I don't know. It looks new, George. You wouldn't be trying to make a fool out of me, would you, George?
Good God, no, Pearl. Nothing could be further from my mind. I've got to go now, Pearl.
It's been a pleasure, George. Don't be a stranger.
Hi there, Dwayne.
Hi there, George. How can I help you, young fella?
Have you met Ultar?
Almost luxurious air-conditioned taxi ride, mister.
Yeah, the cabbie.
Tried to pull a bunco on us. Take us on a wild goose chase off into nowhere.
Have you ever heard of a hill called the Bull's Head?
Can't say as I have. Where's that?
I don't know. I'm trying to find out.
Bull's Head, huh? I must remember that. Sounds scenic.
Have you had any dealings with the kebab seller?
Absolutely not. Pearl's already had one attack of Montezuma's revenge.
Here I have a washroom towel.
Yes?
No, that's it. Here I have a washroom towel.
Oh, well, I was expecting a magic trick or something.
I've got the keys to a toilet here.
Executive washroom?
Not exactly. What does this toilet chain mean to you?
It means that somewhere somebody can't flush the toilet.
What do you think of this?
Looks like the kind of thing Pearl might be interested in. Not old enough, though.
Okay, well, I'll see you around, Dwayne.
Count on it, George.